supernatural love ministry of God,
Amen.
Is having a revival, a 5-day revival.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Up to 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16 next month. And on the 15th, we will have a workshop.
Yeah.
We have 8 hours on radio. I want to talk to you about that. But we can start Wednesday, start doing some of the radio stations.
Yeah.
So everyone attending the revival is pray for me. On your knees. Pray for me.
Yes, yes.
Pray for me, revival. That's what it's about. Pray for me. Revival.
Yes, yes.
On your knees. Because we are needed for that. We're needed for that to come to everyone of their prayer. And if you pray, he said, pray without ceasing.
Amen.
And he will release everything.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. All right, give me a hand clap, y'all. JCN Television, downtown on Island Street. 16th. It's 421 16th Street. And we're here every night at 6 p.m. The bishop has different people coming in to minister, to activate your fountain, to allow you to absorb the Word of God. So let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, first of all, that you have given us the fountain of salvation. So, Lord, as we minister the Word of God, the breastplate of righteousness, activate our fountain of righteousness. This series is a 7-tape series on the fountain of righteousness. So, Lord, I want you to speak, Holy Spirit. Our ears are open and our hearts are like a sponge. We're panting after you. We were seeking after you, God. We need you, Lord, to strengthen our fountain and to resurrect in our fountain the revelation of righteousness so that we can put on the breastplate of righteousness and sin not. Like the man of God was saying earlier, that David was wanting to sin. Sin was always before him, but you were his righteousness. And I thank you for that. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
You know, we want you to go with your Bibles to the book of Judges. Go with me to Judges of chapter 6. Judges chapter 6. Amen. Judges chapter 6. If you don't have a Bible, you can call 949-432-0812 and we'll get you a Bible. It's very important for you to have a Bible, because the Bible is living bread. The Bible is a fountain. This is not a dead book. This is a fountain of eternal life. And it's very important for you to focus on the fountain tonight. Now, we're talking in this series about the fountain of righteousness. Very important that you understand your fountain, because if you don't understand your fountain of righteousness, you'll have the first fountain of salvation activated. You came to the Lord, you accepted Christ, but because you still feel like a worm, like Gideon in the book of Judges, here God was going to give Gideon the whole city, the whole nation. But what happened? First, God had to deal with the way he saw himself. God had to change Gideon's conscience the way heaven saw him. Say heaven.
Heaven.
Saw me different.
Different.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. It's very important when we read this in the presence of the Lord that we see how heaven sees us. All right? It's very important, okay? Come on, sit down, brother, and hear this word. Man, we need you to hear this word tonight.
I just heard it.
Okay. All right, but it's time for you to sit down and study with us.
Okay.
We love you, brother. We miss you.
All right.
All right. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
somebody at the door, so we don't have that again. Because sin totally breaks the Spirit of God. Remember, this is the house of prayer.
Amen.
Very important. And you are the house of prayer. You are the temple of the Holy Ghost. Amen. It's very important that we show compassion, but we also show order. We must show order in the house of God. Because if you don't have any order in you, you're not going to be able to show order in others. If people don't reverence this at the house of God, then one of the brothers, you know, he admitted, I had to tell him a couple weeks ago, sit down, because I saw in the spirit, as the prophet of God, he was going in the bathroom and getting high. And I see it on and on, because the devil does not want you to pay attention. Like the woman of God said, so if you don't observe the word, Joshua 1:8 says that the word must be absorbed and observed so that you can do the word. You can act on the word. You cannot act on the word if the word is not growing in you like a garden. If the word, the Bible says in Psalms 1, I'm like a tree planted by the rivers of water that shall bring forth fruit in due season. God gave David this image, this imagination, this new picture of righteousness. Psalms 1, it says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Okay? Here was a picture of ungodly people, of trees of ungodliness. Nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful, backbiting, gossiping. See, this comes out of that old nature. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. Say, his delight is in the law of the Lord. Now, that sends out a frequency. You see, if you keep talking about what you used to be, what people think you are, it sends out a frequency. Okay? So it's very important that we have to change your nature of your fountain. Because your words are life. Listen to me. Either you're going to destroy your future because of your words, because of the bitterness. The Bible says in 2 Timothy that the Bible said the root of bitterness will spring up and trouble you and many be defiled. You show me a sick person, I'll show you a person that has the root of bitterness. Because the root of bitterness produces a fountain. The woman at the issue of blood had a fountain for 12 years. All the doctors stole all of her money. And the Bible says she touched the hem of his garment and virtue came out. So God was flowing in the fountain of virtue. In the fountain, he was already filled with the kingdom of heaven, right? Mm-hmm. So here's a woman that was under the Abrahamic covenant. She knew about Jesus. Remember I told you about that first fountain, the fountain of salvation. Many people come to the altar, but they never turned on their fountain of joy. So they walk around downtown miserable. Why? Because the misery fountain drains the salvation fountain. And pretty soon they start thinking, I'm not even saved. Because why? There's no picture. So it's very important for us to go over a series in the next 7 weeks over the breastplate of righteousness. You show me a person that keeps backsliding, they're not putting on their breastplate of their fountain of righteousness. Because if you're standing in the presence of God, Almighty God, you will not sin. You won't want to sin. Why? Because you're drawing from the frequency of the throne of Almighty God. And Jesus said when he rose from the dead, all power was given unto me both in heaven and earth. The word power in the Greek means all frequencies. Hello? Y'all gotta hear me now. Cut the TV on and the Cox cable will give you a frequency for their cable. Watch this. Verizon won't come on that network. Come on now. If I turn this phone on with Cricket, talk to me. AT&T ain't coming on there.
All right now.
Come on. And if Cricket cut me off, AT&T ain't gonna cut me on until I go and get a service. So the same thing you're saying when you go to heaven, you're saying, Lord, came, the Holy Spirit was here.
All right now.
The Bible says, God said, let there be light. The Bible said, the Holy Spirit moved over the face of the water. And the Bible said he hovered or incubated a frequency. And that frequency, the Bible says, brought forth light. See, inside of the Holy Spirit is a frequency to get God's attention. That's why the Bible says you must be born of the water and of the Spirit. So when you've got the Spirit in you, you don't even realize that you're giving off a frequency into heaven. Woo! The angels of God and kept around those that fear God. They say, Lord, yeah, that's my son. I don't care how you see yourself. The Spirit of the Lord is telling God, God, I need a house. God, I need a car. God, I need some food. God, I need some Christian friends. You don't even know what you're saying. That's why the Bible said praying in the Spirit, building up your most holy faith fountain. Hallelujah. Why all these good things is coming to you, but the Spirit of the Lord is giving off a frequency.
Come on now.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Jesus.
You are not the person you used to be.
Come on now.
You died, and you are hidden with Christ. Now we're going to read something in the 6th chapter of Judges. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. Remember?
Come on.
Remember? They had a frequency. Watch, in the Old Testament, Vietnamese, black, white, Chinese, no matter what you are, you're made in the image of God, and that's why God can pick up everything you do in the dark, because you're sending off a frequency.
Amen.
Okay. Watch this now. God made man from the dust of the ground. Watch this.
Come on, come on.
Then he said, breath. He breathed the frequency in you. That's why when you cry, Abba Father, he's waiting for you to cry and send him back his frequency. So he can envelop you with Almighty God, with the glory. The angels of the Lord bow down and say, holy, holy, holy in the Lord God Almighty, who was and who is to come, and the earth is full of his glory. That frequency, that frequency is in this building. That frequency. Listen, all we gotta do is release the frequency outside the building. And even the people that didn't want to come in will be slain in the spirit.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
There was a lady named Amy McPherson, a white woman. She used to stay in her house and pray for hours. Hours. And the grocery store, people walk in the grocery store, you know, in the natural, they don't even know what's going to happen. And the Holy Ghost would fall on them. Yeah. And they'd be slain on the Spirit for 3 days. And wait, what happened to me? You've been arrested by the Holy Ghost frequency. We got to stop looking at what people's doing and just release the Holy Ghost frequency on them.
Okay.
Now here goes a man named Gideon.
Okay.
Yes,
earlier today we talked about a woman at the well.
Speak on this, Spirit.
And she knew about God, but her well was not activated.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have come tonight for a prophetic word from God to breathe
on it, Lord.
That your fountain will start giving back to you. Speaking back to you.
Yes.
Instead of the devil talking to you, we bind that voice of the devil and we release the breath of life. Breathe on the Lord and speak back to them that they are the sons and daughters of the living God. You are not who you used to be. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. And it's not just a regular word, it's a fountain.
Yes, Lord.
The Word of God is not a regular book. It's a fountain.
That's right.
It speaks to us in the night.
Amen.
It speaks to us when we're sick.
Woo!
It speaks to us when we're lonely.
Woo!
It speaks to us when we're tormented.
Woo!
He said, am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. When that fountain is speaking louder, then I'm sick, I'm tired, I want to give up, I want to commit suicide.
Yes.
The Lord God said, but I'm the Lord God that healeth thee. I'm taking sin out of the midst of thee.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I surrender all. Listen to this. I surrender my old religion that have kept me in bondage.
Yes.
Come on.
Maybe you was a Baptist, a Catholic, a Protestant, a Buddhist. Maybe you was a Hare Krishna, a metaphysic. I don't know what you've been, but you gotta surrender that night. You gotta surrender tonight all of that so that the Lord can activate your fountain.
Lord.
Now you keep thinking, oh, but maybe the word of God works and maybe it doesn't. No, brother, I release
Amen.
The breath of life.
Holy
and you're gonna start dreaming about heaven. You're gonna start dreaming of the blessings of God.
Come on, come on.
I got a word for you. The Lord said to me to tell you this.
Yes.
There are thousands of blessings and gifts in heaven that God is trying to put on you and put in your life, but you haven't been able to receive it because your frequency was off.
That's me. It's me, Lord. It's me. It's me. It's me. It's me. I'm here, Lord. You're talking about me, Lord.
And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord.
Yes, Lord, I did evil in the sight.
So with that good frequency, they did evil with a good frequency. The Bible says that Adam named all the birds, all the fish, all the everything. God made him in his image. Watch this. And the devil told Eve, don't you know you're going to be like God?
Just how about this?
Listen. Listen. Knowing good and evil, fountain frequencies, is add those two words. Now, she already had a fountain in the frequency of good. But what happened, the devil wanted to change her to a fountain of sin consciousness. So she could be more aware of disobeying God than being like God. When she was created, she was made in the image of God. Yes, she had dominion.
Yes, she's already like God.
The reason why your children and your husband is acting crazy, the devil put on a witchcraft frequency.
Come on.
I wonder why so many people, they was in church, now they smoking crack, now they drinking 40 ounces. You be like, ain't that sister so-and-so? What's wrong with them?
Man.
Well, what happened, we start judging them. We didn't hug them enough.
Oh, come on.
Like the sister said, when we was in the staff meeting, she said, Brother Brian, we got to show more compassion.
Ooh,
so
yeah.
I went home, and I said, maybe that woman saw my frequency was low. In compassion fountains.
Ooh.
Maybe she saw my battery was dead.
Mm.
When it came to compassion fountains in the Holy Ghost.
Mm.
And I know she was telling the truth, because when I was driving down here, this lady, she wouldn't let me get in front of her. She just stopped right on the freeway. And I'm thinking, black, and I wanted that blank, and that blank, blank, blank.
Okay.
And the sister said, see, Bishop, your battery is dead.
I am too.
You ain't been spending enough time with Jesus.
Recharge.
You're preaching a good message. But your fountain ain't springing forth.
Convict us, Lord. Convict us, Lord. Come on. Come on.
I remember I had this Jewish buddy named Barry, and when the spirit started hitting him, he started going like that. White boy, too, from Brooklyn. I didn't know that boy ain't gonna be dancing like that. When the Holy Ghost got on him, he began to go all the way, he began to shake up and say, Lord, the spirit don't bury me. See, the spirit need to get on us.
Yes, yes.
Another thing that heaven is telling you, stop getting offended when God is trying to activate your joy fountain. When you get corrected.
That's right.
Yeah.
Come on.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
That's why I had to go back to the sister and say, you know, sister, you was right.
Mm.
See, it's okay to be corrected.
Yes.
The Bible said when God chastised you and correct you,
yes,
it's because you're a son or a daughter.
Yes.
But if God don't correct you, you a bastard child.
Yeah.
Come on now.
You don't want no bastard child fountain flowing out of you.
No.
And you.
Come on now.
Is Brother Brian a bastard child? You don't let him want correction. Hello?
Ooh.
The Bible says in Jude, they became twice dead. They were beyond correction. The Holy Ghost stopped getting grieved. The Holy Spirit left them. Oh, that's terrible.
Yes.
Because they wouldn't get corrected.
Oh.
Now there was a man named Gideon. The Bible says in Judges 6 that all of Israel had sinned. They were releasing, listen, they were releasing a frequency of evil like Adam and Eve in the garden when God came down in the cool of the day. He didn't come down in bodily form. God is not flesh. God came in his spirit in the frequency of wholeness, holiness, and he got to a man who had given up
his frequency of heaven.
Come on now. All right now.
He said, Adam. He wasn't talking to Adam. God showed me this. He was talking to Adam's frequency.
Come on. Come on now.
To rule and reign and command. Because when you're all sin conscious, you'll be hiding.
Yeah.
First thing Adam did with his frequency now of the devil is got like this. So Bishop, when folks start hiding, when you're driving down the street, you know they done sinned. Just breathe on the Bishop. We gotta charge these batteries a little bit more. Come on. You say, hey Bishop, I love Bishop. You say, come on in here, baby. Let me pray for you again.
That's right.
Instead of pouring out the compassion of God.
Oh.
The bishop is a, this is his gift.
That's right. Yes, it
you
is.
Ain't better than me, Bishop. That's just your gift. I've been wanting to tell him that for a long time.
Glory.
I've been sitting in the car watching the bishop. And man, the bishop is just lovey-dovey and patient and long-suffering with folks that I would have gave up on. Folks that you would have gave up on. But I heard the young man testify. And I went back to my house and got on my knees. I said, wow, that was the fountain coming out that boy. Bishop turned that boy's fountain on. See, me, I was kind of rough with him when he was going in the bathroom because I wanted people to be still. Come on now. But the Lord said, why you didn't grab him and hug him and tell him you love him? See? And so I apologize before all of you. Because I'm working on my fountain.
Me too, me too.
I just got out of prison doing 60 months.
Thank you.
And let me tell you something, that was the greatest test I ever had on the fountain of love. With the gangbangers, the Bloods, the Crips, the homosexuals, the lesbians. There's some guys thought they were lesbians up in there. Child molesters. But the Lord began to deal with me about Gideon. I saw everybody had sinned, even me, even though they threw me in there and I was innocent, but I sinned before God.
Come on.
Like the minister said. See, sometimes we want to blame everybody else and say, Lord, did we sin in your sight?
Lord, did we sin?
Stop blaming everybody else.
That's right.
I remember the Jewish woman came in and said, oh, my sister stole $1 million and I'm a husband. Well, no. Look at yourself.
Amen.
Don't blame anybody for being homeless or getting a divorce or whatever.
Yeah.
Did you show the fountain of compassion?
No, I didn't.
Did you cut down your hedges of your fathers?
No, I didn't.
Okay, watch this now.
And
the hand of Midian prevailed against Israel. Now watch, Israel now goes into bondage. The fourth fountain. The Bible says to preach deliverance to the captives. So as I'm preaching to you, I'm activating your fountain. Job 42:9-50 says, and the Lord turned the captivity of Job. God, I got a word for you. I got a prophetic word to you. Say it with me. God,
turn
the captivity of Job. And gave him double what he lost. Your old fountain will remind you of what you lost instead of the new fountain that says, God, turn the captivity. Heaven is crying out for you to just say that. Lift your hands in the presence of the Lord and start saying, God
has turned
my captivity. I'm going to be the owner of the business. I am not an employee. I'm the owner.
That I may be healed.
Confession of your sin.
I did.
If the Bible said, he that hideth, here goes a fountain, he that hideth this sin will not prosper.
I broke every commandment. Every one.
So here is Gideon.
I broke every one.
Watch Gideon. But watch. Today I breathe on you.
Holy Spirit.
Said,
Holy Spirit,
he turned your captivity.
Thank you, Lord.
You're not in bondage anymore. You're not in prison. I'm an elderly lady. When I first got out of the joint, I started talking like I was still in the joint. And the probation lady was trying to put me back in the joint. She wrote all kind of lies, right? I love you, Miss Huxman. But you lied. But the Lord gave me this lawyer called Steve White. You ever need a good lawyer? That boy is off the chain. He went up in there and said, well, the only thing that Brother Tomlinson has done, he ain't paid his fine because I didn't have no money. Some of y'all know what it feel like not having no money. I couldn't pay my fine for 6 months. The company had fired me, so I was like Gideon. But here God was telling me to take dominion.
Amen. Yes.
We must take dominion. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Because if you don't take dominion for God to turn your captivity, you'll still be captive-minded.
Come on now.
You'll still be spiritual-minded in your heart. See, the Bible says, whatever is in your heart is going to come out your mouth.
Amen.
I want you to think about what you've said for the last 24 hours. That's your treasure. And that's why you ain't kicked by the bondage. That's why you don't got a new car out there and a new house. Because God said he watches over his word to perform it. The Bible said as the rain and the snow come down from heaven into earth and water the earth, so shall my word be that cometh forth out of my mouth. Now watch. There's a stage of God's word coming out of your mouth from God's mouth. Now remember, God lives in you.
Amen.
So when you first start quoting God's word and commanding that the blessings of the Lord, the blessings of Abraham, the thousandfold return will come over your life, what happens is it's coming out of your mouth and your soul.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
But watch what happens. When you begin to pray in the spirit over that scripture, your spirit comes in agreement and starts matching equally the word.
Ooh, that's what God. Ooh.
And now God
word. Okay.
Starts taking what you gave him,
that's right.
The Christ in you. Say the Christ in me.
Christ.
You got the Christ in you. You got the man who walked on the water.
Yes.
The man who raised the dead from a 4-day death.
Yes.
You got the man who opened the blind eyes, took 3 loaves and 5 fishes and fed 5,000. And pull the fish out, and there's gonna be a pearl in his mouth. Go pay your tax. Boy, I wish I would have never went to prison for taxes. I should have went fishing, brother.
Yeah.
Got them phones off. Keep calling right now. 949-432-0812. I hear you calling. Glory to God. You're observing this word. So the first thing God began to say, In verse 4, and they had camped against him and destroyed the increase of the earth till thou came to Gaza. And left no substance for Israel, neither sheep nor ox nor ass. Now this is what's wrong right now in the downtown area. We're paying more attention to people in the tents than the abundance of God.
Amen.
First thing we see when we drive down here is homeless people. I don't see homeless people. I see temples of the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Lord.
I see people waiting for me to activate their temple.
Amen.
I'm telling you, you got a fountain in you. A lot of y'all been raised in the church. Some of y'all may know the Bible better than I do. But the preacher never activated your fountain. So you keep thinking, oh, I love God, but there's no power in you.
Yes.
The Bible says, and these signs shall follow the believer. Amen. Mark 16:17. I read that when I was in prison on a 40-day fast, but something happened when I read that and I prayed. Shabbat. Well, and these signs shall follow the believer. I said, well, why ain't nobody coming to the Bible study, Lord? And the Lord said, and the Lord added. Shabbat. I don't think y'all saw it. And the Lord added unto the church. And great grace was upon the church. I said great grace is upon you. You are the church.
Come on.
You are the temple of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. And great grace was upon the church. I said, great grace is upon you.
Yes, I see.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life.
Hallelujah. I see
grace. So David was reading this, but he was also looking at the hedges of his father, the witchcraft. There are things that your father, grandmother used to do, you know it wasn't godly.
That's right.
And that same image is clogging your pipes. Until we get the hedges torn down of our families, these are trees growing in your past subconscious fountain.
Sycamore tree.
So sooner or later, if I come up to you and hit you, and you may say, Negro, you're not going to hit me. We're going to start boxing, right? But there was a guy in the book of Acts. They took Peter and John and whipped them. Now, I've been listening to this tape for 9 months. Seriously. But it hit me yesterday when I was listening to it. It's on auto reverb. 24 hours I listened to this scripture when I'm at home.
Thank you, Lord.
And it said that Peter and John rejoiced after they got a whooping because they said that we are even worthy to get a whooping for Christ.
Wow.
Now, how many of y'all, if you walk out this door and somebody starts beating the hell out of you, you're going to say, praise the Lord? No, you're not. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But when the Holy Ghost came over John and Peter, I ain't saying I'm there yet, but I'm trying to get there. They began to whip them. They was going to whip Gideon. They said, oh, you tore down our demons. You tore down our hedges. When you start tearing down folks' demons, when you start tearing down folks' trees of the wicked one, they're going to get mad. Hallelujah. They're going to run up out the church. But they still want to eat from that old tree. The Bible says the devil told Eve, don't you know you're going to be like God, knowing good and evil. When she partook of that tree of evil, a tree started growing in her. Because her first son was a murderer. That tree of that disobedience metamorphosing into a character and an action of murder.
Wow.
In fact, he killed his own brother. He didn't just kill an enemy. He killed the brother who gave the better sacrifice. So another thing you gotta watch,
come on.
When you start getting so spiritual, the children of the flesh that you think Christian brother and sister are gonna start persecuting you.
Come on.
Amen.
They're gonna say, what if he thinks he's better than me? He ain't better than me. thinks he's more spiritual than us. Yep. Why? That's that old fountain. That's what happened to Gideon. Watch this in verse 8. The Lord sent a prophet unto the children of Israel, which said unto them, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, verse 8. I brought you up out of Egypt and brought you forth out of the house of bondage. This bondage represented famine. When the frequency of evil gets on you, you're going to start going broke.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Every financial storm of drought runs when a demon of sickness, disease, famine, and evil. Somewhere you released a frequency of evil, because the Bible says in the famine, Isaac prospered a hundredfold. Why? He knew where to dig for the water.
Amen.
Where everybody else was dying. Cows was dying, sheep dying, kids was dying. Watch now. Let's go to 1 Kings 18. The Bible said God fed Elijah from the river and from a raven who used to bring him food. Watch. And
come on,
the river dried up. And then God said, go to Zarephath. I have commanded. See, God said he commanded. So all you got to do is seek the face of God. God's going to show you who he commanded to help you.
Come on.
He said, I've commanded a widow woman to help you. Now watch. Old Samuel, no, excuse me, old Elijah comes into the gate. You see this old widow woman? She can barely walk. He said, hey, go get me a drink of water and bring me something to eat. Now watch what came out of her frequency. What? She had been watching everybody else die. See, if you keep watching all these homeless people die, go broke, living in tents, that's your treasure. You got to come up out of there and go to La Jolla and just walk around the way. How you doing? How you doing? Hey, they don't know you don't live there. Unless you tell them. But if you start giving out a frequency, man, there's one of these houses in La Jolla for me.
Yeah.
Who's to say that you won't have one? You are the only one that's stopping you from getting your new house and your new car. Because if you sit in this church for 3 days and pray,
yeah,
and say, Lord, change the way my frequency sees me.
Thank you, Lord.
Because Jesus' frequency saw abundance.
Come on.
Every time they had a problem, he said, bring it here.
Yeah.
And he created the solution. You have creative power called the fountain of creation in 1 Corinthians 12, he said, 1 Corinthians 12, in the spirit, who hit Nika, First Corinthians 12 says, and the spirit of God, the Bible says, it says, severally by his will. So speed up, can't walk out. When you pray, you begin to align your will, your appetite, your desire with the Holy Spirit. And you become equal with God. I said, you become equal with God, the provider, the healer, the deliverer. So Elijah spoke back to the woman. He said, bring me some water and something to eat. And the woman said, I'm going to make me 2 biscuits, one for me, one for my son, and we're going to die. Because death had entered her picture. But I cursed that picture in you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I cursed that evil picture of the tree of death and evil in you in Jesus' name. And no man shall eat of that tree from this day forward. And I breathe on you the tree of life, the tree of eternal life. You shall start bringing forth from your fountain the tree of eternal life. Glory to God. And I saw a pure river of water proceeding out of the throne of God and the Lamb. And I saw a pure river of water proceed. And that proceeding river of living water is coming out of you right now. In the name of Jesus, saturating your mind. Hallelujah. Saturating your will. Lining you up with the will of God. And the Bible says the woman brought back, listen, some food and some water for Elijah. For the God in Elijah. And the Bible said her needle bowl and her basket, her flour and her water and her oil did not run out. Now watch this. I had read that for 30 years. y'all been preaching that. Watch this. But when I went to prison, God interpreted it.
Yeah.
It says in the book of John 5, excuse me, James 5.
Yeah.
You probably read it just like I did. It says that Elijah had passions like we do. Remember? He had desires and appetites that wasn't lined up with God, the glory provider. Watch, because when he started preaching, Jezebel said she was going to kill him, and he ran to the mountain. Here, he just rained fire down from heaven and prayed.
Yeah.
Lived through the famine. And one little woman ran him out of the city because she said she was going to kill him. Because he prophesied she was going to get licked up and ate by dogs. And she was so mad, she sent people to kill him, and he was afraid. See, fear will come out of your spirit if you don't curse that tree. If you don't command that tree of fear to be cursed in you and wither up by the roots,
yes,
you will not believe in the God in you.
Yes, we are.
Because the God in you is faith. But the old nature found in us before we got saved, what? Is fear. Because we're hiding.
Oh, yeah.
And now you got saved. Curse you me. Came to the Lord. You got on your knees. Lord, save me, Lord. You believe you was for real.
Yeah.
But watch. The Bible says in John 15, he that beareth fruit, God will purge him. The word purge in the Greek means to take out the old roots of the old you.
Take it out, Lord. Take it out, Holy Spirit.
This is where the war is. That's out. Why you keep having one frequency of salvation. You know you saved, but the other frequency you still were like a devil.
Come on.
Right. And I can back this up with scripture.
That's me too.
Because in Galatians 2,
that's me.
God gave Peter a dream in the Acts chapter 10. I'm going back to Gideon, but I got to drill something. I'm drilling oil.
Speak to this man, Holy Spirit.
Amen. And God told Peter, when I am cleansed, don't call it common nor unclean. So that fountain started growing in him. He started accepting other religions and other nationalities to come to Christ because he thought only the Jews could come to Christ. Watch. But God was dealing with Paul in the 12th chapter of 2 Corinthians, and he was also being tormented by a demon. And then he said, Lord, this demon keeps attacking me 3 times. And God said, my grace fountain is sufficient for thee. Why? What is grace? Grace is a fountain. Grace is springing forth. Remember I told you the root of bitterness will spring up and trouble you and may be defiled? Well, the Bible says in Isaiah 54 that your health shall spring forth speedily. Woo! So now you got wholeness springing up from the Lord.
Okay.
And you got the root of bitterness springing up from your past.
Okay.
And you have never allowed the Lord to purge you from those old fountains.
Wow. That's right.
So they're draining you.
Ooh, wow. Yes.
And you know, man, something's wrong.
Ooh, yes.
Something's wrong.
Come on now.
Something's wrong. So I went to this place. It was called Landmark. And the lady was saying something real powerful. Now, I haven't saw my father in 8 years. I gave his partner $50,000 and he robbed me. The prosecutor told him, if you help this man, I'm going to ruin your life. So he ran out with the money and he ran off to come down and tell the truth. I should have never got 5 years for tax evasion. First time you're supposed to get 6 months. But the Lord had to put me in that prison, in that cage, because he had to deliver me from my bondages, from my father's father. Because my father was a whoremonger. My grandfather was a whoremonger.
Yes,
my grandmother died when my father was 18, and my father now hates God because he thinks that God killed my grandmother. She died of cancer because she was bitter against my grandfather, because they were rich. When they came from Jamaica, their brother owned Blue Mountain. That's the richest coffee in the world. That's my grandfather. When they had five apartments in the 40s, in the Depression. And my grandmother was a saint. She always was helping the military and feeding the people, feeding the poor. My father said, I'm like her, because I'm always down with the people that need Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
But she died because she didn't know how to use her fountain. She didn't know how to pray for my grandfather. And so when the lady started talking about blind spots, say blind spot.
Blind spot.
You know, the Holy Spirit opened a veil. And the blind spot she was talking about is my relationship with my father. Because me and my father, see, my father wouldn't allow his friend to be taken down, so he made me the sacrificial lamb. So when I sat in the prison, I tried to forgive my father. I've always tried to do good and become successful for my father to praise me, because my brother was named after him. And that's what we do with our kids. We treat one of the sons better than we do the other son. And that's why Absalom tried to take the throne of David. Because he was not loved like Solomon. And so the Bible says Absalom slept with all the virgins of David's. And he tried to take over the throne. And because David killed Uriah and took his wife, that spirit, that frequency came in his house. And one of the boys, the brothers, became a rapist. He raped his own sister. The spirit of the devil hopped on one son. Now watch. He was becoming a catapult. If you don't deal with these hedges and these roots, it's going to go on your children. And the Bible says the one brother, he was from a different mother. And the Bible says when the brother Absalom found out, because Absalom's sister was the one that got raped. Right? Oh God, we praise you. Oh God, we magnify. Cut it off, Sam, for a minute.